Onivia, League of Legends Highlights.
Matchup when you are the Akali trying to dive somebody that will also have a Shen ultimate protecting them. So really curious to see if Bolulu can deliver on this out. And if a fight breaks out, you know that Armut doesn't have teleport as well. So this is just a free Dragon 14 look.
Cal here in mid as well. Jensen going to go back in. He may have taken the bait, but he's going to dodge the swell seed, but no ulti regardless. Jensen not going to nick the Akali. Ultimate flashes out of there. Has the extra dash if he needs it, but that's going to be for escaping as Broxa does at least take the dragon.
Even though...
the tactical trying to get some plates of his own. Oh, good grab there. Snowfire going to let the ulti rip, and that's first blood. Easy as you please for Zeitnot.
That was really easy, actually. He's very squishy. That's a lot of damage. And Burst that can come out of Supermassive doesn't allow for the Spirit's Refuge.
Set of crumbs. Shen just not that tanky with just the Tiamat. So that's going to be the Herald charging in. First tower gold over Broxa with impact on his back. And Jensen TPing in is going to try and make a play happen. A double taunt impact finds them both. And that's one kill. Make it two as Zeitnot's going to fall to Broxa.
Such a nice use of the teleport to Shen to the top side if they really want to save the turret. I think Supermassive is just giving it and will trade for damage and maybe the turret. Yep, he's just TPing to the
soul. Oh, Armut
doesn't see him.
Wow, that's such good use of Fog of War.
Oh,
gonna leap out. The plate goes to Jensen. Jensen's gonna get out of there, but he's about to be attacked by Snowflower as well. There's the ulti, there's the hook, and see you later, Jensen. Armut's gonna pick up the kill.
Damn, Armut is so good. Like, that's something that a jungler usually knows. Make sure that the setup is right, that the Shen can have the ultimate and have it actually go through. They're going to get some vision down here, clearing out these control wards. It looks like Team Liquid still have plenty.
Ooh,
they're going in.
There's a submarine as well. Cordo J going to dive in, but it's Snowflower that's caught up in the crossfire. Tactical going to gun him down as a result, and Team Liquid have themselves a nice fancy 5v4.
Ooh, okay. Supermassive is positioned if they want to take another 4v5, but it seems really risky to go for them. They should just go for the Herald and for the Dragon, and that's the power of the Shen, being able to surprise you with the team fight. A long 5 is an insane situation around the Dragon Pit. There's no Rakan ultimate, so Akali can find an angle.
Yeah, Baloo looking to surprise somebody. The dragon getting low. Who's going to grab it? The smite goes down. It is Broxa that nails it. And now Baloo maybe going to go down. He flashes over the wall. Jensen going to find him with his own ultimate. And that insult to injury as he slays the mid laner of Supermassive.
That didn't look like an attempt at a fight. Remember, you know you have one pick. You can now take a fight knowing that you have an advantage. And this is just methodical pastry. Yes.
Keeping the farm and the items close. We'll see if Jin can start unleashing his own bullets the next time a fight rolls around, because we're going to have one. Crumbs in a minute and 37 seconds.
We will have a fight, but if Team Liquid has shown us something, is that they don't want it fair. They're going to go and
do it again. Blade of the Ruined King into Shen on top of the AD carry. Five. See you later, Snowflower. You're now in trouble. There's the ulti out of Rakan. Going to get charmed up as Impact
Baron
will take him down, and straight to Baron they go, Crumbs.
On cooldown, they see the ultimates. They know that there's members that are possible pastry. I think Team Liquid's about to get it, but they're going to turn.
Yeah, Kakao's just going to get peeled away. They're going to slay him. Broxa having to take him down so easily as Armut's spinning around in the back of the team by trying to make something of this situation. But there is nothing left but to watch the Baron die and go over to Team Liquid.
Surgical precision out of Team Liquid, just knowing how they were going to play the fight.
I like how we highlighted how good Impact Shen is, and Team Liquid have just found a way to make Impact Shen even more impactful.
Oh, right.
Good hook there. On the Broxa they go. That's a very critical pick if they can get it, but he's not dead just yet. Baloo diving in there, trying to find the pick off at the Jin. Ulti's going to try and catch a Straggler. Tactical in trouble. Double sleeping coming. Kakao's going to set it all up. The hook is there. Make it two quick ones there for Supermassive. Streets 112 all over Worlds as Jensen is able to find one back. Perhaps there is the only ulti. Impact is trying to get in there. Does flash through. Perfect execution. That indeed is Jensen. Dives through. Takes down Zeitnot. Takes down Baloo. And Team Liquid will not be stopped.
Nip it out. Just takes her time dancing and prancing. But it will be safe.
I don't think it matters. Impact's up in 10 seconds. He's got ulti. I think they can just play the 2v2 for now and then have Impact come in. Armut's going to go for it. They have to kill this jungler. Broxa is low. Getting spun on. He does get shut down. Perhaps I take it back. Supermassive are going to take this dragon away unless Jensen can do something heroic. No, it's not. It's Kakao that gets it, but they will get a kill for their trouble. They're actually going to get two, perhaps. Yes, as Kakao will fall to tactical. So Team Liquid will be...
Dragon, the Ocean Soul was going to be able to slow down those auto attacks. So Graves was never able to group up with the Sylas. And so he gets taken down in the pit. Luckily, Supermassive stalls out on that dragon.
Impact taunts out. Impact's relative. No, he's not tanky enough. I take it all back. Zeitnot just going to put a bullet in his...
Not only does he have the protection of Core JJ with the redemption and the Zeke's to buff him up, but even Impact is chipping in on the support style itemization. Lockett and Knight's Bowser. The time's going to land in. Core JJ going to shut down Kakao. Snowfall going to be the next one to fall, perhaps, as they will take down the tower. Here's Nautilus ulti out of Jensen. That's going to be a decent chunk of damage. Jensen dominating his arm. Wood's going to spin into the team. But now Baloo over the top. Good stasis there. And he's so low already. That exhaust could not have come sooner for Core JJ as Tactical is now on a killing spree. And Team Liquid don't need the brand. That's going to crack through the top side.
They've had enough. That was so decisive out of Core JJ coming in through out of vision, immediately engaging onto the unsuspecting Lilia. She just gets burst right away. They get an inhibitor, and this top inhibitor is going to be what? So even trying to execute him is going to be nearly impossible from Supermassive, guaranteeing the Twitch to pop off. The stealth is through.
Oh, Kojiki again. He's going to find the three-man charm. And there's Jensen on top of Zaynod. He's dead already as Armwood is trying to spin through the rest of the team. A second spin is going to happen, but Team Liquid, I think they've peeled enough. No Tactical. He is going to go down. But do Team Liquid have the damage to finish off the fight? Indeed they do. Brock and Jensen wreaking havoc through Supermassive as Snowflower is going to fall to complete the ace and the game for Team Liquid.
They don't need the Ocean Soul. They have the Nexus Pastry, and Team Liquid very cleanly proving to be the number one team in Group A.
And certainly looking like it here. One win away now from getting straight into the main event of Worlds as they take down Supermassive to keep themselves undefeated here in the Worlds 2020 play-in.
Tool in case Mad Lions wants to engage onto you. Something like a Shen is going to have a really hard time against that. That's such good vision. So I like that the control ward gets placed on the right side of mid lane there, and then the regular ward at the blue buff. This should allow them to have complete vision of what's happening in that jungle quadrant. So if you don't see that the Graves is there, you can go for those dives. You can continue to pressure them and have another avenue for a teleport potentially. So now they see where the Grave is at. Here we go. Looking for maybe the Alistar. Jin has flash though.
Yeah, Raid's going to have to play this well, but Isles is going to be the target. He's got no summoners except the Ignite and is going to get aggressed on the Ignite. Is down. That's going to be first blood over to Kazi. But now Shadow going to get locked up here. So Vip's going to try and trade it back. Here's the TP in from Legacy. It's Toppoon looking unstoppable as he pops the Bellow's Breath. And there's the ulti out onto the Edgewheel. He goes. He's going to finish him off. Oh, he's lonesome. And there's the damage. Raze has it. There's the follow-up as Tally's joined in as well. And Legacy punch back the two. Oh, it's a 2-for-2 trade. Never mind.
Oh, okay. The Aura ends up going down. Shen doesn't get to channel his Herald. That was a long ways. That's a strike.
It is. As Soul Seed finds two there, Shadow gonna try and finish off the Rift Herald, as you mentioned, but Babip and Tally do have an inkling that this is happening. So it's gonna be a 3v3, perhaps. Tally, oh, he's got Predator Boots. Quite spooky here is Galio. All in ulti, they're gonna go for it. Oh, that's a kill! In they go, the sleep is there, but it's too late for Shadow as Babip finishes it off.
She's so squishy. She cannot get in the face. Thus far, you want to see him have just the confidence to be able to play around Lilia, but so much of her kit is about just kiting away and towing between the lines of dying right away and just getting that movement speed off. And another fight to the bottom lane.
Oh, Isles, what a flash! He's going for the play! Onto Kaiser he goes, gets the restart there. Is it support or combat? But it's Isles that picks up the kill.
What an Alistar play! This is why they didn't go Leona. You can do Alistar and outplay your opponents here. Karzi can just walk out of this one. He'll be fine. Has no flash here. They've already secured the Rift Herald as well, so they're going to have a fat turn of events. You're winning a Skirmish and a Herald top, and another one in the bottom lane with the Dragon. This is going to allow them to just continue to recover the Jhin.
To find not just individual leads here in the top lane, but trying to get vision and make it more here. It's Huguenot going to be the target of this mid lane gang. In goes Tally, but he's so low already, but here's the ulti out. Collateral damage is massive into the combo. Isles is going to get Huguenot to sleep at the wheel, though, is Babip, and Shadow's going to get the trade, but it's going to be a second there for Legacy as Tapoon storms in to pick up Shen.
Stand United use that gets a negative fight for Mad Lions. Legacy's just having a great time here dealing with the Shen. Now the Ornn is even further ahead. The lanes continue to do fine, and that means that you're not going to have the Shen ultimate for the setup around the dragon. It hits, though. They can sleep this Jhin.
Nope, no ulti, no luck, but Ray's still going to get locked up here. Here comes Kazi. Ray's is dead to rights, but the trade kill maybe for Isle. Shadow is low, but low's not good enough. That's going to be a second as Mad Lions actually maybe going to save the day is Tally, but it's a 1v3 now for the Galio. He's got no flash. He gave gave up his life to save the Alistar.
That's not worth it, saving the Alistar. He's not.
Alistar can. Here they go, moving in for Vision. Galio's not here yet, though. He would like to use his ultimate, not the teleport, to start these fights. And Shen is already rotating over. Both teams are very hell-bent on taking this dragon fight.
Yep, gonna be almost all 10 in mid here. Isles gonna be made drowsy. Kaiser gonna attempt it. It's a Hex Flash attempt though, so pretty low cost for him. Here's Tapuno, he's seen the angle. Oh my goodness, Isles! There's the Galio ulti down as well, but everyone's flashed out of there. And a great triple stun for Cumulon on the other side. But Kaiser now gonna be the target. Another great taunt there for Tally Legacy. Just need to find these few precious kills, but Bip is so low. Tapuno's gonna be the ulti out of Cinder, and Cumulon again! A triple stun to turn it back around for Mad Lions as Tapuno is low, but will not fall.
Oh, pastry. Mad Lions had an amazing scatter of the weeks here. This play's not over though. Double teleports. Okay, a party's happening.
The scene one, Tally's gonna charge up the taunt, but he's gonna try and get a different target. Shadow
gonna be the one, Tally, even though it's raised, that gets the dragon, and now he's gonna start shooting down the duo lane. Oh, he gets one in the air! Oh, Kaiser, last bullet! It's not enough, it does hit him, but Arome.
And now Legacy gets to crash these waves. What started off as their engage ends up finishing as their objective win.
Yeah. To very valuably up 3,000 gold right now as they take down those towers, but Human are going to even that back up a little bit. Looking about 2k.
They'll find that combo. It has to be on the right targets. They can't avoid or they can't afford to have the engage go on to champions that can just dash out or flash away, and now you have no.
After all the time that's passed, so he's trying to chuck Swirl Seeds in, but Legacy just want to finish this objective if they can. But there we go. Isles in again, gets the double knockup. Dragon goes over to Bibip, and there's the knockup follow-up there as the Alistar does get the knockup. But now the triple drowsy there. What a sleep there for Shadow. Here comes the Orn. He does get it there onto Shadow as he is going to get killed with not being able to get Bibip or Tapuno. And now Ray's in there, but he face checks everyone and gets blown up by Humanoid. So at the end of it all, it's a dragon.
Another tier 2 nice and easily. No answer here from Mad Lions.
Nobody was there. A teleport trying to catch out Humanoid. They don't know that he has. Well, they know that he doesn't have flash, and they're just gonna flank him. Let's see if Alistar gets interrupted here. Tapoon's looking for the E.
An ultimate here. Smoke screen down. Humanoid gonna get knocked up. Finds two actually tallying with a taunt. A massive taunt as well as Vivip's gonna get the shutdown. Here comes the Galio ulti on top of it as Raze has already taken down Shadow again. That Fawn is just so squishy.
They can go for Baron here. Let's see if Karth and look for a way to turn with the taunt and the root. A TP is through. Look at Alistar looking for a flank.
Gonna look for it, gets a double knockup as well. The root from Jin is good. They're gonna get the pick here. Kazi, he's gonna take down Isles, but Arome is trying to take down Raze. The damage is massive. The Baron with the assist as Arome is gonna prevent Legacy from taking the objective.
It felt like Mad Lions sniffed out. Mad Lions just calm and collected. Defuse the engage from Legacy.
Yeah, really well played. That was a much needed reprieve.
Done.
Gonna look to shove down mid here, and that tower will be forfeit. No real way for made to parlay into either the Baron that they didn't quite get thanks to Orome's great teleport and the Ocean Salt they weren't able to get thanks to Mad's great division and team coordination. Ooh, Isles face checking. Pops the ulti. Humanoid's a target. He does have flash though, and that's not recommended. Isles gonna have to flash out himself.
Oh, then losing that flash on Alistar is such a big deal. He's
just
gonna
dead.
Die.
Yeah, Kazi, really nice play. Unfortunate, I think Isles just too ahead of his team there, and that Wiz is going to give pressure over.
There's no Scryers here. Graves is healing up. Will they drop some Vision over? They need Vision. They hook the Ornn.
Tapuno does Galio. Not eat the taunt. There's Tally. Finds a three-man taunt. Damage is there. Humanoid gets destroyed. There's Legacy looking for the re-engage. Tapuno in onto Shadow as he's going to finish him off. There's Galio over the top as well. Shadow is dead, and Raze is going to cut it out and take down the Nautilus. Now Arome in a 1v4. He did it last time. Can he do it again? Trying to rescue the team, but he's going to get slapped down and shut down as Tally's going to take out the Shen.
Legacy turn the 4v5. Alistar not needed. Ooh.
Kazi is really, really scary, and he's going to be put to rest finally.
Dead.
The final kill they needed, the shutdown for Tapuno, and that's going to give Legacy the Ace and the Baron.
Support difference there. The Alistar just doesn't have to be in the fight, clearly, because Legacy can 4v5 their way onto a team fight win and a Baron pastry. They have just turned this around. What looked to be Mad Lions clawing their way back, not letting Legacy get ahead of themselves. Soul that Legacy so desperately wants.
Yeah. Ray's weaved in and out of that fight so nicely as well, but it is the two soul laners that come up big there for Legacy, Tapuno and Tally.
find the angle to give them this Baron. And they're still going. Tally looking aggressive, finds a Taunt onto Kaiser. Pops the Stone Plate, gonna try and live. But Babip is over the top. He wants blood as Kazi cannot be caught. But here's Tapoon, gonna try and find it, but he doesn't quite get it. Instead, the collateral damage is indeed gonna give Tally the kill onto the Ezreal. And Legacy looking to barrel down mid at this point.
Lilia just keeps getting caught. She is 1-6, and Legacy have no hesitation in picking on her. They have the Hex Flash from the Alistar getting real close.
Humanoid! The root. That's not it. Here's the Jhin ulti. See you later. Syndra flashes out of the way. Last bullet. He jukes them all, and he is going to live. Had the flash after all as Tapoon is going to tank up quite a lot, but they take down the tower. Still not done a Legacy. They're trying to finish off this inhib, and they will be able to do it. 35 seconds until that dragon is up and available, but Tally...
They know they have vision. It's going to be up to Mad Lion, Scryer, Zorb, the Ezreal, and the Lilia to check every single brush, but they don't have enough time. They don't know what Legacy is up to right now. The one control ward will at least see the tanks. They don't know where Graves and Jhin are. As far as they know, they could be at the dragon. They see the fight.
Has to hit a trap. He doesn't have Stone Plate. He's going to get blown up. It's Pavip that gets it. Now Isles over the top, finds Shadow. Going to keep the jungler out of the equation. Arome also can't tank everything. Tapoon finds another ulti and onto Humanoid. And Humanoid this time absolutely has no flash as the collateral damage is going to clip him. That's going to be a kill for Tapoon as Kazi takes down Raze to try and keep Mad Lions in a Razor's face. Says it all in the play.
Ending the game. They're going to take the consolation prize, if you will, of getting the Ocean Soul here. But now Mad Lions have to deal with a ton.
It's on the only ward in this area currently for Mad Lions.
Double Scryers on the side of Mad Lions, and we'll have the Ezra ultimate soon enough, so let's see what Legacy chooses to do around this Baron. They're gonna rush it. They have enough sustain here. No Scryers used just yet. There it is. They see what's happening. What is the position of the Alistar? Look at him. They don't know where he's at.
Watch
he's
in the Tally too. He's looking for a TP angle. Isles pops the ulti, looking for go in there. Here's Tapoon getting the ulti down. Gets a good two-man knocker, but here's Tally back around the side. Humanoid's gonna have to get out of there. Tally can't quite get in as Isles is low, but he's not out just yet as Mad Lions trying to kill these tanks. But Tally kills Humanoid. It's Kazi now that he's locked down, but Tally once again finds the Taunt. There's the double kill as Isles will finally fall. But Legacy is still trying to finish up the job as Kazi's being such a nuisance as Kaiser, his lane mate, will fall down.
I think that's it, Pastry. Mad Lion's trying to cut the minion wave, but the Jhin is already topside. It looks like they might have actually stalled enough to stay in the game, but they will still lose an inhibitor.
Papoon is just going to try and make Kazi's life miserable here. Oh, Galio is getting in there.
Oh,
see you later. Kazi does so much damage. And now they're blowing through the top side. The TP's in. Legacy know they can end the game right here and now. It's only Arome to defend with 15 seconds left on two teammates, and I don't think he can do it by himself. He's kept him in the game as best he can with the Shen plays, but Legacy are going to knock down yet another Nexus and push themselves to 2-1.
Tally was such a hero in some of the most...
The Mad Lions to make it into group,
like
lose
Wukong.
This game, and INTZ go home winless. How many Mikau is losing?
Yeah, he's down 10 CS at least for now, because it looks like Tactical's pushing the wave. They're going to contest this crab. Shinny doesn't have the E. I believe he's on the crab. He does take it. Looks like it's going to be a fight.
All right, Cordia Jane Tactical first to move. They are going to be now surrounded.
NBC
that's
first.
A route onto Tactical. He's locked up.
The
Flay will buy some time. Teleport coming in from INTZ. Shinny with a fantastic pullback. First blood secured by INTZ. Tactical is flashless, healless, and he is in so much trouble. One last auto, and Tay picks it up. Shinny unlocking the lead for INTZ.
And that's the early jungle mid prior we talked about in the draft, right? Orianna has the push. She moves first. Shinny
first. It indicates the plan. Jensen finishes the TP. He's flashless, and the Hex Flash comes in from Shinny. Needs to be able to land the full combo. Jensen's
TP for
out
impact.
Of range, out of vision, and the gold card will connect. Now, Impact making his way with the help of Broxah as well. Envy's bitten off more than he can chew. Impact turns his attention to Shinny, and just like that, Team Liquid find themselves a counter.
Good response from Impact. Broxah was quite far away. I think he just about finished the Krug camp, ran down. And...
Hasn't pushed too much vision deep into the territory, and Redbert will be backing away and think he'll just spot Broxah taking that blast cone over the wall. So we'll be fully aware the red buff is stolen. Shinny arrives and he's definitely a sad panda. That control ward is just taken out there inside.
Out, Jensen,
that's
flash.
The flash, the engage, the hit buff pulverized, gold card comes out, the unbreakable.
The phase rush, baby.
Phase rush does it for Redbert.
That was a good response from Redbert. Instantly flashed in as if Envy goes for the fight.
Dominance.
But...
Control. Phase rush. Headbutt, pulverize, and instantly running away. That was that quick combo that you were talking about, Kedril. But
Shinny's
look at the support!
Here.
I didn't even see Shinny and Envy! They make their way down. The Shockwave catches Tactical, but here comes the Destiny and the Gate. Core JJ connects the death sentence, and Envy is sentenced to death. It ends up being just a kill to Team Liquid. The response was fantastic.
Yeah, and INTZ, they did have good mid-jungle prior. They moved towards bot.
Their farming ability, the mechanical ability, and the response to the pressure they're under.
But Broxa hasn't responded with the Dragon in the first 10 minutes. I think now they won't really have much Dragon pressure. I like
the Dragon and the threat, the looming threat of the Sol, enough to counterbalance the 1,200 gold lead that Team Liquid are in.
I wouldn't say so. Looking at the champions, gold on the side of Renekton and TF is a huge, huge deal. If they can get to their 2-3 item spikes,
they're up as Shinny and Envy have walked straight over a ward from TL. So Team Liquid fully aware of what's happening, and I think they're trying to play bait.
Yeah, that ward in the river is huge, and Shinny and Envy kind of need to do this. Impact has TP, Jensen has the ult, so if they're the ones to react to the play, they're always going to lose. So they're always trying to be the first ones. As Shinny gets drowsy, the TPs are coming in as well.
Shockwave is still available for Envy. He hasn't pulled the trigger. That's a headbutt coming out. Redbird's going to look for the pulverize. Knocks up poor JJ, but Shinny's already dead. Here comes Tay. He manages to pick up Broxa. Impact has joined the fray in the fight, and that Blade of the Ruined King is wrecking Tay and Redbird.
So Impact identifies that. He realizes he's weak side. Give up the tower, trade it for the bot tower, and we'll get a Drake as well. So net advantage for the side of TL, and the gold lead is still even. It's about 3,000 gold that we've seen across the last couple.
And this is a fan base that I've personally been interacting with and talking about, because, you know, I remember the golden era, INTZ, when they're playing with Revolta, when they did pick up a win against EDG. It's been such a long time.
Oh,
now
Broxa.
It looks like Tay's going to be making a play here onto Broxa. The Dawning Shadow will help out, get the assist.
That was illegal.
And that was just an easy pickup onto Broxa.
So, clean, so.
So we know Team Liquid, they can set up this 1-3-1 and Impact. Level advantage, you get pulled backwards by the Shockwave, manages to slice and dice and Ruthless Predator into Envy's face. Not a huge loss. With the help of Herald, this will pick up the second time of the game for INTZ. How do they disrupt? Got the Titan, the Tiamat completed as well. And currently looking to be the shining light here on the side of INTZ. He's found himself Jensen, but Core JJ is coming to back up. The Enchanted Crystal Arrow did not find a target. Fantastic death sentence over the wall. Now Tay's running for his life and he's downed. Cast a curse of note just as I was praising him.
Just keep trading vision topside, try to back off and just keep respecting it a little bit more, because TL don't have too many options right now.
Okay, well, TL will take that dragon. It's the Infernal secured. No pressure here from INTZ. As far as of yet, I'll stop doing this. This is Kedril's thing. He does it much better than I do. But I do think the one thing I wanted to call out was that if INTZ can find...
Oh, maybe he's getting arrested.
In the Baron Pit, the Shockwave is available and not yet used. Finally, in the last...
Cast a curse.
That's it. Cast a curse. It's not my fault. Do not blame me, North America. INTZ will put pressure on this tower, but look, Team Liquid, they've not backed away. Mid take it out shortly. And that initiation was just to put pressure on the inhibitor. While it didn't get the inhib, huge kudos. INTZ are not done yet.
Yeah, and Envy's... Oh, is he gonna get out here? Okay, just about gets out. And Envy, he invested his team.
But Impact was able to escape. I was waiting to see if any further shenanigans would play out. A minute and a half until the next Infernal. Remember,
no flash
on Tactical. Redbird, he gets the headbutt. The pulverized Atlantis available. He's dead. He's done. INTZ find their 7th kill. Now Tay has picked the fight with Impact. He's locked inside the baby cage. The Shockwave is still available, and so is Command Protect. Dawning Shadow comes up. Flash forward, Shockwave. Shinny gets Impact.
Do they go Baron? Maybe they can. I mean, Tactical tried to contest midway. We just said it 30 seconds ago. If he walks up...
Uncontested. Is this the right call?
This is the right call. You can't contest this Baron. The Destiny spots everyone out. You know there's no way you're going to walk in there. The set has all... There's just too much to walk into. And they traded for mid-tier 2. It's a good identification. It's not the best thing in the world, right, trading Baron for mid-tier 2, but it's the best that they could do in this.
Recognized it in-game. I think Redbert has been one of the initiation superstars this game. 1-0-6 on Alistar. This phase rush combination has been working, and now with the mid-tower secured, 5-6 for INTZ and TL, and it will be the second Drake. Sol is going to be a long time away for both teams.
It's a long way away. We're talking 10, 15
seconds,
minutes.
And it looks like they will put some pressure on the inner turret. The box down from Core JJ. That's a small win, and they will get the tower as well. That's
good
a long range
setup.
Initiation. They held on to the
hex. Almost went in there. I was expecting it.
Kedril, you said it's an even game. I think INTZ may just be in the lead.
They have a much better team fight comp for sure. TL, if they keep getting caught out one by one like this, Tactical has no flash, Core JJ has no flash. They need to clear this mid wave. I think they should be fine defending this in here, but the dragon's in 50 seconds. Oh, the Impact.
It's a good pullback. Impact is
huge shockwave.
Fantastic shockwave. There's no further follow-up. Dawning Shadow is just on cooldown for Macau. 45 seconds to Baron, 40 seconds to Infernal, and INTZ stick on the turret.
Good chunks. They might be able to get this mid tower here. They might go for the inhibits as well. Impact can't TP behind, so they are going to back off. TL is coming out of base with the home guards, but this is anyone's game, Trevor.
10 seconds to Dragon, and INTZ are the ones making the forward move.
Tactical and Core JJ have no flashes. Broxah might have to flash here as well, and without flashes, you can't walk up against Orianna.
He goes
if
golden.
He dies, they can get Baron.
I think they're going to. That is a dead Broxah caught out of position. INTZ are going for the inhib first.
Yeah, they're going to go for mid inhib. Bot inhib's open as well. They have a top wave, so they could look at three inhibs here. Definitely two if Tay goes in and pushes the top wave. So mid inhibs goes down, they're going to move up the top side, and then they have two choices. Do we want to go for three inhibs, or do we want to go for Baron and Dragon? Or do we want to try and end? They have the Camille ult, they have the Orianna ult, Alistar has ult as well. They could try and end this.
Oh my word, are they really going to? Let's find out. The step forward is on. INTZ now starts to back away. They've got the supers, they've got control, and they've got objectives to.
So I think they're going to go up top side, put the wards. Envy or Taze and go towards the bot side, play the 4-1, try to threaten the inhibs, and TL, they need to make a pick. Jensen and Impact.
Yeah, there's not a lot of threat just yet. Broxah finally making his way up. The blast cone has already popped.
Redbird.
Destiny has been used. Redbird throws down the Unbreakable Will. Core JJ can Death Sentence and Lantern across, decides not to.
Good.
And the Baron easily secured. Now, is there a follow-up fight? The answer is no. Double super
now
mini.
Now you can see they're going 5-man bot. I would like someone to go mid as well to sort of get the waves in, perhaps Tay. But it looks like it's going to be a 5v5 stare down. There's no tower, so if INTZ want to engage this, they can, but Tactical has flash really soon.
Well, listen, the 5v5s have gone the way of INTZ over and over and over. INTZ win here will set up that tiebreaker with Mad Lions and replicate yesterday. That's it! Tactical's dead! He's down! There's nothing he can do against the Envy Shockwave. There is a reinitiation here from Core JJ. He's pulled backwards by the Showstopper. He manages to help set up the kill into Macau. But now Core JJ and Impact are trying to do what they can. That's another pullback from Shinny, and Impact will get taken down in a matter of time. The Slice, the Dice, the Ruthless Predator will not be enough. And take a look at that. INTZ are not yet eliminated. INTZ will take down the undefeated Team Liquid. And INTZ will face Mad Lions for a shot at playoffs.
Trevor, history repeats itself.
And now we'll find out whether the set or karma will swap, but I anticipate that
Kakao doesn't play the safe. He doesn't clear his own jungle. Both these junglers are sort of picking and prodding at what they can get, right? Kakao comes down, pushes Babip out, takes his red. Now Babip gets pushed out. He's looking for his raptors. So Babip, Armut's moving down. He might have to flash away here.
Damage here. Babip is in trouble. Needs to get over. Oh, he doesn't do it! You can't get away from the crushing blow. It started the animation, and Armut gets the kill. Not only does he get the kill, Zeit not alive, and try to get him to 200 years. So for team fights, that'll be the expectation we want to watch. And Kaedril, just as you talked about, with the pressure in the bottom lane, with the advantage that Kakao's been able to accrue, easy pickup on that Mountain Drake.
If they do start it, Armut will TP in, but they're on a timer. They have to start it now. I believe it looks like on the minimap they have. So this could turn into a 5v5, or they could just let Armut get the platings by himself.
Supermassive want to start this one. Kakao's waiting in the wings. Javelin
toss. He has a good TP ward behind.
Movement coming in here from both.
There it is, he's TPing on it.
Fall of the Forge God is started. The secondary proc interrupted by Snowflower, but he's put to sleep, knocked in the air, and put back in the fountain. So Poon gets the first kill of the game for Legacy, and they turn their attention to Zeit Not. The lose condition activated. Legacy find two quick kills. Get the teleport out of Armut as well. And frankly put, win the initiation. Now, Tapoon gets caught up by the Glitter Lance. The Cyclone goes in, as well as that Warrior Trickster. Multi-man knock up the Wild Growth. Give Legacy some air miles, because they are flying! Crushing Blow to the face sets up another kill for Armut. Now he's forced to retreat and run away for his life as Isles and Rays are focusing him down. While that's going on, inside the pit, Tally is being whacked away on by Kakao and Bolulu. He's able to escape with his life thanks to the Flash, and Snowflower, after being the first to fall, returns to the river, and it ends up being a 1-for-4 in favor around the pit. Tapu's still got Call of the Forge God available, and the rest of the team are here. Do they want to pick the fight despite the dragon going down? While Legacy may have the gold lead and be a little bit ahead of the tempo here and controlling Zeit Not, two dragons for Supermassive cannot be denied. Call of the Forge God, secondary proc, and there goes the Wild Growth. Snowflower misses the dredge line. You need to land that if you're going to Spider-Man your way out. So, Supermassive get the dragon, Legacy get the kill.
Yeah, Snowflower, no flash, and we talked about the engage.
Legacy are still in lane. 20 CS advantage in the top lane in favor of Armut. When he picked up first blood, he had that blue buff, and he's been able to bully Tapoon just a little bit.
Yeah, Tarpoon's basing. He's going to TP back here. There's no ultimates for anyone, really, apart from Zeitnot. They've used everything in that fight, and they need to try and steal this. Babiff needs to get in there.
Let's take a look what happens. It's going to be a smite fight. Supermassive get it. They're one away from the soul, but now they're stuck inside the pit. Can they get away with their life? Defensive flash by Snowflower and Legacy are trying to shoot fish in a barrel. Supermassive are just stuck inside the pit. Look at that. Mystic shot off the Mystic shot. And they're
only
just daring them.
Kakao can jump as well, but
into the fight. Finally, Tarpoon fancies a shot. I've never seen fish in the barrel like this
before. Whack-a-mole.
This is just straight up whack-a-mole. Mystic shot misses. Keep firing the skill shots. There's the interrupt. Finally, Snowflower catches onto Tally. He's looking to whack down on Snowflower and the rest of Supermassive. One, two, three quick kills. Ormit stays alive in the pit, trying to use those crushing blows and that Nimbus strike the best that he can. Isles will escape with his life, managing to lifesteal on the W. And finally, Ormit takes him down. It is a crazy fight as a 4-for-3 so far. Ormit's running low on man, and I think he's going to be forced to run away. But that was ridiculous. Inside the pit.
God, Trevor, that fight was so long. Regardless of the kills, Supermassive picked up the third dragon.
The fight. Next time round, they'll at least have the eye edge for Zeitnot. But now they are dealing with even more itemization. And by the way, there's only one tower that has been culled. It's down in the bottom lane. The second will do so now.
Yeah, Supermassive has no flash on their bot lane. Ornals comes out. I think he's dead.
Well, let's find out. That's a dead Snowflower.
They just
sniped down by True Shot Mirage. And Supermassive's response is to take the top tower.
Yeah, they're going to trade two towers for one by looks of it here. And Raze dashes forward. Zeitnot has no flash
as
well.
So much damage. 2.5 items.
This Ezreal is online. Look at his kill. 7-1-4. Raze is just carrying the game for them. It's like Armut versus Raze this game. And then you've got Tarpoon on the Ornn who's playing super.
6,000 HP on Baron. Kakao does not have
Raze
flash.
Can dash out the pit.
But he does have Cougar form to pounce. All of a sudden, there's the engage. Tally manages to pull two together. Armut still got that showstopper. Bolulu dead before anything can happen. The Cyclone doesn't matter. Now Snowflower's in. Finally, the Cyclone comes down, but Armut is killed. Snowflower will be the next to fall, and Zeitnot wasn't even there. Legacy can go back to the Baron.
Off, Trevor, 10-1 in this tiebreak in this game. He's going for the second seed, for the tiebreaker against Liquid, and Raze is just carrying them so well. But Tali and Tarpoon are doing so good on these engages, helping Raze find the fights, find the damage that he needs to put out. And Raze got hit by a spear at the start of that fight. I thought he was kind of out of it, but he did manage to get the damage down. And wow, the team fighting from the side of Legacy is crazy, and this all comes down to
a gigantic deficit. Earlier this game, they were in a literal hole, the Baron Pit hole being shot at by Legacy. Zeitnot tagged by the Swirl Seed. Babib's gonna hold on to the lullaby for now. True Shot Barrage does nothing to Armut.
Raze is a one-man army right now. With the shields from Isles, he's just kind of standing in their face, zoning them out alone. Tally, look at Tally. He's not on vision, he's coming behind. There are flash on Supermassive, but he's got Bululu maybe.
Call of the Forge God comes out, and Snowflower does it again. He interrupts yet another Call of the Forge God. Three members from the side of Supermassive trying to focus down Tally, simply can't do it. Snowflower's dead. The Wild Growth will not be enough to save Supermassive, and they will be aced. Legacy are destroying Supermassive.
Tarpoon TPing in mid, I'm not sure if they can
kill, death, assist column. 14 of 20 kills for Tarpoon. 19 of 20 for Babbitt. 15 of 20 for Tally. 20 of 20 for Raze and Isles. It has been a team effort. It has been team deficit, and Legacy have all the tools they need to close the game out before Zeitnot becomes a problem.
Yeah, Raze has kind of been taking over the game ever since that early Herald fight that Supermassive opted into, the 3v5. Tarpoon, is this the weak side, please?
Well, let's take a look at this. One versus three, by the way. Here comes Tally. He's ghosting his way in. Snowflower's going to be the first target, and feels like it's just a matter of time so he gets shut down.
Armut
and Zeitnot in trouble. That's a flash forward from Arnott. Moonlight Vigil will not be enough to save Zeitnot. And yes, the Wukong is going to jump in and pick up at least one,
That's two.
At least two. But here comes Babip. He's got himself those blooming blows. And he will be able to get a counter kill, but Supermassive, they're still defending what is going to be 2v3.
Big shutdowns for Supermassive. If they can hold this Nexus, it's sort of like a breath of fresh air for them. I mean, Raze, he did have Isles by his side, but he didn't have Tali and Tarpoon. He didn't have the front line in front of him, so Armut could jump onto him with Bululu, and it was kind of like a 2v2, and they did lose it in the end. Lots of damage onto the side of Raze, so Legacy, not a huge mistake. They got the inhib, they got a couple kills, and Armut did pick up the shutdown, so it will help him out, but that's not really...
They're guaranteed first or second in the group. If they take down Team Liquid, they're guaranteed the group stage.
Guaranteed group stage
for the first time. Don't let me down, Oceania. Let's see if they can close this game out. They have all the tools they need to.
Starting up the Baron.
Baron is at risk here.
Can't dash in there. Nidalee is a good champ at stealing Baron. If she hits the Q, dashes over, gets the Q smite from the Cougar form. So Lexi need to look to turn this.
Tali gets caught out there by the Dredge Line Call. The Forge God will knock up two members. Zite not forced to run away. He's now in position to fight. And Snowflower's already dead. Supermassive are caught out. The Vigil does not matter. Babip is just going to run down Zite not and blow him with some blooming blows. And all the damage onto Tali now. There's the damage from the Cyclone. This could turn around. Onward, can he get any of the carries though? Isles is still alive. And with the fact that Raze goes untouched, Legacy can turn their attention to the base. That's a teleport onto the Nexus turret, and Legacy may just have done it. Bolulu running for his life. Raze wants to pad the stats. Gets turned into a munchkin for now, but with the Mystic Shots and the autos,
oh, look at that damage.
They'll be able to kill him.
Oh, he was emoting him! He didn't want to finish him!
Unbelievable!
He was PMing!
The emote does not do it, and it will not matter at the end of the day. Snowflower has got four members of Legacy to deal with. And Legacy will take down Supermassive and face off against Team Liquid for the top of the group.
OCE tied for first place in the
set. Kog'Maw, and it'll be a TK instead of the Thresh. Similar thing, looking for Peel. This will be the first time we see the Tahm Kench, and we'll give you some of the
trough.
Okay, well, yeah. I didn't know that.
Just so you know, I know, you're young. I'm teaching you some things too, you know. I've got a few in the bag
Thanks
that even you don't know.
For blessing me with your knowledge.
Right, so let's carry on now. The power trough phase is currently underway. Arome has that flash available, holding on to it for now, and he gets just dunked down. It's Tay that picks
This is so good for INTZ. They can herald top towards that Triforce now. 240 gold from the plates, 400 gold from the first blood, but Kaiser's up here. I think it's going to be a 2v2. The TP's behind them.
This is very low levels at the moment. Shinny forced to flash, goes golden for the time being. Here comes Arome. There's the Nimbus strike into the crushing blow. Gets enough damage down to get Mad Lions their first kill of the game, and it lands in Shadow's back pocket.
Yeah, good play for Mad Lions there. Arome using his TP to actually gets them. They want Tay to push outside, deny gold by doing it by minions, have the Tahm Kench and Senna use their globals, but INTZ are looking for a fight. They don't have TP on Tay.
Shinny's going to use the Hex Flash. Mad Lions will be able to pick that up. A Showstopper comes down. Shadow will get taken out. Okay, losing one, but picking up the Dragon and getting a teleport, probably worth.
Definitely. I think having a straight 5v5 and losing it when you're scaling with these champs is not the best thing.
And remember, of course, when Rothschild was looking at being started a little bit earlier, it was Shadow that got a little caught up. That's the flash. Shockwave, here comes Kaiser. Solar Flare lands down. Will there be enough follow-up damage? The Devourer from Redbird keeps him alive, but the burn will take him out. Humanoid and Kaiser find the kill themselves up the second Rift Herald. Mad Lions will now stop putting pressure on the bottom outer, or the top outer goes down.
Yeah, I think we talked about it in the draft. Kog'Maw is so immobile. Humanoid instantly pulls the trigger because Envy had flash the bot side, so Tay can push aggressively. You can see him on the minimap now. Moving in there, he's going to scatter all his wards around, light it up. And someone's going to have to catch Top Wave from the side of INTZ. I don't think they should drop them. Investing a TP, INTZ vision is definitely more beneficial for them, but Tay is going to the top side. He doesn't have TP, so I'm guessing INTZ are going to give this up, try to contest topside vision. Baron's coming up soon, and it's either Ocean or Infernal. It's Ocean Soul, so INTZ, they need to start fighting.
The loser of this game goes home. One win, three losses, and the tiebreaker defeat. 20 seconds until the Dragon. Some decent vision here from INTZ, and looking, there's a teleport up.
Ooh, that Shockwave.
That Shockwave is not really going to do enough. Humanoid's running for his life. Come on, Protect keeps him alive. That's the Showstopper. Flash away from Humanoid. Shinny gets devoured up, spat out. Shadow takes him out. True Shot Barrage flies across the INTZ backline, and Mikau and Envy are trying to spit back.
Mikau.
Living Artillery is doing so much work. So far, it's a 2-for-1. The hookshot goes long range. Hextech Ultimatum locks in Shadow. Arome has held on to the Cyclone. He manages to get the knockup. He's locked down. He's rooted. The Living Artillery is doing so much, and Arome gets taken out.
It's an ace.
Mikau and Envy stay alive. Mad Lions are aced.
It's a 3-for-5, Trevor. I don't think they can do Baron. I don't think the game's kind of set and done. They're going to get the Dragon for sure, so they're going to deny the Ocean Soul point, but next fight is going to be critical.
There is too much to follow and so much threat. Envy and Mikau played, you say it out loud, but to execute that flawlessly under this much pressure, exceptionally well done. INTZ will lose their mid outer turret while no teleport. INTZ,
I think they can rush this.
Fully aware of it. Now Shadow will have his flash available by time this is going down. It's a couple seconds out. He's got the smite available to him. Humanoid's going to be so low. Collateral damage, flash, smite, 2000 HP. Arome's got the Cyclone as well with initiation. Baron is going low. It's picked up by INTZ. Now can they win the fight? Cyclone knocks up one, knocks up two. Redbert will be the sacrificial catfish and INTZ so far look like they can get out alive.
Such good decision making from INTZ.
And his split pushing has already been terrifying.
Three level advantage. He just hit level 17. Three levels up with a GA and a death stance. Look at the Roma's items. He doesn't even have a death stance. He has a Tiamat.
This man has something to prove. This man has something to say for the small mistake of teleport at the beginning of the game. Now he will get jumped on Shockwave, Cyclone. I mean, every single ultimate has been used. That pops the GA. Look at the rest of INTZ. They're pushing in the mid lane. So yes, there is a kill.
Weak side police.
Weak side police. Woo woo. The alarm has sounded, but at what cost? Because of
20 seconds on the dragon.
Tay's come from the mid lane. He is flying through the jungle.
Good
TP
response.
Coming in here from Arome, and the rest of INTZ begin to back away. We've got a 5v5 setup in the jungle. Who's looking better right now?
This is what I want to see. I want to see INTZ pushing this midwave and go back towards the dragon. You're going to have so much control. Engaging here is a bit risky, but Shinny's looking for it.
They absolutely are. A lot of damage on the Shinny so far. He's forced to flash defensively. Arome manages to find out Tay. Hextech ultimatum goes down. Defensive flash, hook shot away. The command attack and collateral damage takes out Tay, and that means Mad Lions in the chaos find themselves a kill and buy themselves some time. Kazi goes all the way forward, takes a lot of damage from Mikau, misses the Mystic shot, and ends
look at the poke
spitting away the living otter.
Mad Lions, they're on Ocean Dragon Point. It's all points.
Unbelievable. It's still 1,000 gold separating these teams 31 minutes into the game. The item disparity between Arome.
Last couple minutes, but the Ocean Soul will last forever. But INTZ, they've regained control of the map because Mad Lions were down in tempo. They had the base. Tay's going in here. It's 1v5.
They're engaging so hard. Here comes Shinny over the wall. Tay's forced to run away. His GA's been popped, but he hasn't got Kaiser just yet. Kaiser escapes with his life. The Cyclone's huge, and Shinny goes down. Arome's chasing Mikau, and Tay, Redbird's sitting inside the middle of the Mad Lions, and Envy is using that living artillery to the best of his ability. INTZ lose one, and Mad Lions are pushing
to it.
Gets chunked out there.
INTZ on a timer.
This is the soul, down to 3,000. INTZ are going to be very late. Dragon is going to be secured. That's picked up by Mad Lions. Europe and the LEC will have the buff. Now Tay is under threat. Smokescreen tags him out. Mad Lions turn their attention to the INTZ back line. Flash is still available for Humanoid, and Tay is over.
God, Mad Lions have the game sort of in their hands. Ocean Soul is so powerful.
That's not very confident. That's a flash engage. Redbird is under some trouble. The shockwave's not been pulled yet. Shinny
shockwave
and Tay waiting. That's a shockwave used just for Redbird. Mikau with the Dawning Shadows. Here comes Shinny. Redbird finally goes down, but Envy's in a fantastic spot, spitting the poison from behind the chicken camp. All of a sudden, Arome with the Hextech ultimatum needs to get away. That's the flash QW that Humanoid was looking for. Mac and the rest of the Mad Lions crew are cheering behind the scenes as the Blast Cone brings Shinny and Tay to safety, but Shadow's not done yet. The flash forward, end of the line. Collateral damage is on cooldown. Kazi is looking for Envy. The spit, the damage, the living artillery, and Kazi does it.
That's
the third kill as Shinny's the next target.
Arome needs to go to mid now. He needs to TP there now. If they can stop Tay from basing, they should be able to end this. There's 40 seconds on the carries of the side of INTZ. Arome hunting down Tay here.
He's trying to find him. Shadow as well. This will be a 2-on-1 while the rest of the Mad Lions are pushing into the base. This is a lot of damage onto Shadow. Tay's going to look for the precision protocol. He's putting so much damage out. The tactical sweep buys some time. GA will proc. Keep your eyes on the minimap. All of a sudden, Redbird is up and alive. Tay continues to chase for Shadow when he's down.
Is Arome going to TP in the base?
And Shadow
here it comes.
That's the teleport. Nexus turret number one is down.
In 3 seconds.
Nexus turret number two is down. And for the third year in a row, the CB LoL fall flat at the tiebreaker. Mad Lions advance to the knockout.
Your Shen ult is kind of being used defensively here, but the lanes are kind of contested. So if people want to collapse, there's going to be a fight here. But Broxah has the smite, so he should be able to get this one down. He has flash as well in case Tali wants to go in, but he's turning onto Babic here.
A lot of damage.
Look at the collapse. It's going to be a 4v5. It's going to be TP's 5v5 maybe.
Isles and Rays, and these are the team fights. That's a long range dash. The taunt comes out from Impact. Everybody's in the river except Tapoon. Team Liquid get first blood. 90 Calibernet will find a target. So Rays escapes with his life. North lose less to a Tapoon, even with the wave under his tower. He's still behind in CS. So very early advantage to LCS in North America, and Team Liquid. Before 6 minutes, they've already got themselves a dragon, they've got themselves a healthy gold lead, and they've got everything that they need.
So they're going to have two solo lanes pushing, and not only that, they have the bot push as well. So Jensen has no flash here, he could get called out.
Ultimate is available for Jensen, it is not for Babbitt. Hero's entrance comes down.
Ooh, big damage.
From Tali and Babbitt, there's a hop over the wall. Broxah managed to pick up the second kill, making it look oh so simple.
Tali to join these fights, and just look at the CS. Tali, no flash again.
Man, no flash available. That's a dash in. He manages to get the taunt to just buy some time. Broxah on a killing spree, 3-0. after getting all the crabs in
the enemy jungle's top side, you can try to swing bot side.
Okay, seems to be the case. Brox has already cleared out Grump. He's pinged out on that ward. Legacy aware, but look at the damage onto Rays and Isles. Collateral damage is available. End of the line. Can bounce against the wall. Get away from the wall!
Big damage.
They don't get away from the wall! Collateral damage gets the one. And Rays and Isles, when Graves is chasing you, get away from
the first dragon. That's coming up in a minute for the ocean. But they do have the Herald, and they're going to need that to pull back a lot of gold to look competitive.
The only disadvantage for Legacy taking that Herald, and we see Impact taunting in, he's got so much damage with Babips here, I think there might be a TP. Jensen doesn't have TP yet.
What happens? There is the ability to save Tapoon's life, but it will inadvertently heal Impact as well. Mounting Dread, Wolf's Frenzy, the Dance of Arrows over and over, and the ultimate not used. The first kill on the board for Legacy. Now Raze and Isles come back into lane. Brox's collateral damage is available, and AC in the hole sends Isles packing. And that is the fifth kill of the game, the first for Tactical.
Yeah, they're going to get this bot tower. And like I was going to say before, the whole bad thing about Babip sneaking that Herald is that when you're running against the Shen, you want to swap into the Shen and play into him. So it kind of takes away the identity behind being able to put your bot lane sort of basing, drop a wave, run top, four-man top, and then just try to kill the Shen and just play on his lane. But Babip definitely identifies what he needs to do. Play on the Shen's lane so you avoid the Shen ult. He does manage to take him down.
Yo, Kedro, I don't know if you know how the Shoutcast and Joe works, but you don't ask me questions. I can't give you the answer. What, like, how did Legacy respond? I am not qualified. I was actually looking at items, if I'm going to be 100% honest. But for the time being, look at this lane swap. I mean, Legacy, they are down so far, dude. Like, the only way that you can try to bring back this deficit is farm as safe as you can, but you're losing more plates, you're losing more towers, which means TL are getting even further ahead.
Yeah, Tali has the ult if they want to try to defend this, but Impact has his ult as well, and Tapoon doesn't have TP, so it would be a 5v4 in between the towers, and I think Team Liquid would be beneficial in that. They're so strong right now. Look at Brox's items. It's kind of unleashed, and Jensen was around as well, so I think it's complete one. Maybe they're going to look for the dive, actually, if they stay too long. They do have the Kindred ult to buy time, but Tapoon will not be able to join this fight, and if Impact decides to join, it's a 5v4.
All right, Tali needs to move. He's making his way through the Brambleback for now. There's the potential to dive under. Look at that end of the line damage. The entrance comes down from Tali. This is now
V4,
and that's exactly the case. Not going to be enough damage just yet. The quickness will at least lock down Proxy. He's running for his life. The curtain call is being blocked up by 4JJ and a three-man taunt from Tali. They are down 5,000 gold, and they almost make the fight look competitive. But Team Liquid have the damage, the items, the HP, and they can look to dive once again. Jensen has already used the high skill button, his ultimate, and now he's going to look for Scatter the Weak to set up something more. Scatter the Weak won't get stunned. Babip being run down by Broxa. Teleport coming in here from Impact under the tower, and Raze will get taken out by Jensen. This is illegal gameplay by Team Liquid, making a statement in the tiebreaker. TL want groups, and they want it over the corpse of Legacy.
Legacy trying to defend that top tier one. I mean, it looked pretty good for TL. The Syndra, the Caitlyn, the Graves. I think those champs scale really well comparatively to the other side of the board. So Legacy, they're going to lose the Dragon. Maybe they can cross map for this top tier one, but they need to find some sort of engage to get this game.
Get an A ball
rolling.
For one last time today, it wasn't Ornn's fault, okay? The Holy Trinity of Pixelman, 0-0-1.
They get impact, but they won't kill, but now they're looking for something.
Right, all the Forge got immediately destroyed by 4JJ's Braum. Look at the damage onto Isles. He's running for his life. That's a dead Raze as he gets blown up by Ace in the hole and the auto attacks from Infinity Edge. I mean, if you look at the player cams, Raze is just like...
That's G2 when they were against Team Liquid.
Touche.
They were on their Nexus in 19 minutes. It's 19 minutes now. TL almost got to return the favor to Legacy, but there's two TPs coming in now.
Oh my word. Let's see what can happen, as that's already Tali going golden in so much trouble. They almost get Tactical. 90 caliber net flash heal used to keep himself alive. Raze is trying to run him down, but he doesn't have the damage. He doesn't have the item. The cleanse does nothing. Tactical stares down the entirety of Legacy, gets away with his life. And Legacy threw everything in the kitchen sink at Team Liquid. Yep. This could be a sub-20-minute victory.
Yeah, Legacy, they had to make plays. We said it for the last couple minutes. They went for that last-ditch effort, but Team Liquid are gonna—they're probably gonna win this game. I think they can end here. It's probably a record time in the planes itself.
This looks like it. 19 and a half minutes. Isles staring them down.
Team Liquid qualify for the world's group stage with a few last autos. Got to finish this off before I celebrate it. Legacy trying to step forward and push them back. There's the hero's entrance. Team Liquid cannot win in under 20 minutes, but they find themselves one loss on Impact. Continue run for the lives. Tactical. 90 caliber net in a reply, and the bullets will not find. Curtain call cannot do it. Finally, Tactical goes down to Tapoon. Jensen and Broxa are trying to finish this one out. Jensen gets another. It's Broxa that is godlike at 7-0-9. And just to make sure, it's a lot under 20 minutes, the final fight. Team Liquid advance to the group stage at Worlds.
What a performance by Team Liquid. Win lane, win game. Not only did they win lane, they almost won the game in under 20 minutes. They played so well. Broxa, Jensen,